out to California right now. We are getting this fresh update on the wildfires that rage in that state.
Just a couple updates. The entire complex is just over 131,000 acres. We do have over 30,000 structures that are threatened. We do have 105 confirmed structures destroyed and 70 confirmed structures that are damaged within the entire complex. We do have 4 civilian injuries, and we have 587 firefighters currently at the incident. As a reminder, anybody that needs information, we have a 24-hour information line at 707-967-4207. Again, we like to ask to please hold any questions until the end, and we'd like to get an operational update from our operations chief, Chief Blankenheim. Chief?
Hey, good afternoon, Charlie Blankenheim, Ops Section Chief. So I'd like to say a quick update on this, but it's not going to be real quick because there's a lot to talk about. So the Myers Fire, further west fire, it's back down in the Pacific Ocean. We've held it to Myers grade, and it's still backing down into Fort Ross, but we're making pretty good progress on that one. That one's in pretty decent shape. Our number one priority for the day and our most dynamic fire from yesterday is going to be the Wall Bridge and the Stewart. They actually merged overnight. The Stewart ran down into the Wall Bridge, and so we're now going to treat it as one fire. Crossed Mill Creek yesterday, made a little push to the east, and is continuing to push south towards Guerneville and Rionito. We've got plans in place for protection of those communities, but a lot of work needs to be done, and very, very active fire yesterday. Had significant structure damage and significant structure loss yesterday coming off the Stewart. We'll continue with that today. Moving over to the Lake County side, so we'll start up on top. We had the fire in Jericho Valley yesterday that made a significant push, and then the Morgan fire from 2 days ago made a significant push to the south and to the west, or to the east, and they're combining now. So what used to be the Morgan, the Jericho, the Gamble, and the Green, and the Spanish, those fires are all combined now and continuing to push down into Rumsey Canyon. And along Highway 16, they're backing down into Rumsey Canyon. As they come down and hit Highway 16, our plan is to go ahead and hold Highway 16. We're reopening the dozer lines from the Rocky Fire and the Jerusalem Fire in 2015, I believe. We're reopening those dozer lines to come across the top and to come down towards the county, the Napa and Lake County line.
Yeah.
Moving down into the very active situation, the Etna fire that took off was one of the last fires to start 2 days ago in the Butt Canyon area. Was very active during the day yesterday. Continued to burn towards Pope Valley, towards Butt Canyon. Significant structure defense going on in there. Lots of structures, lots of infrastructure in this area. This fire will, if it hasn't already, will burn all the way and tie into the backside of the Spanish fire. We're doing structure protection, trying to keep it out of the communities, out of the structures, and it will. We anticipate it tying into here. So moving down, coming off the peak down here, both directions with dozers. Last night we got the plan in place. We're bringing dozers off the peak here, Dallas Peak, going both directions down towards 128, and then working south. So we have a plan in place to build this western edge. We've got some additional resources on it today, and then building this western edge is going to be one of our main priorities today. We come down towards crosses 121 and down into the Vacaville Fairfield area. The fire made another significant run yesterday late in the afternoon. Crossed I-80. I think you probably saw it on the news last night. Lots of excitement. 80 was closed for several hours. Fire was on the other side. We picked up the spot across 80, somewhere in the 500 to 1,000 acre area. It's contained, and now we're building line back up from 80 to work up into Gordon Valley and to hopefully get this bottom piece tied in. Where the fire ran down into Vacaville 2 nights ago, we're doing really good in there. There's still a lot of active little pieces in there, yards on fire kind of thing, trees, fences, stuff that's still burning, still poses a very significant threat to structures. So we're working on getting all that cleaned up. We're fairly confident that we've stopped the spread and that hopefully there won't be any more push down into Vacaville. We'll be able to keep it where it is. We're just trying to keep any additional structures from being lost. So with the fire back to 128 on this side now, so we've taken dozer line and crew work and go on County Road 87, and we did a firing operation last night. We went about 8 miles, so this map is not completely updated. What's going on? We went about 8 miles, firing 8 miles up. They're going to finish that tonight, and they'll be tied into Esparto. So then the bottom side of this fire and the top side of this fire are going to combine, and the Blue Ridge will be all interior, and the Blue Ridge is going to go ahead and burn again. And then again, we'll be holding Highway 16 in Rumsey Canyon all the way back up to where we tie in here with the Morgan Fire. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Chief. Next, we'd like to get our law enforcement speaker and law enforcement partners, Chief Sheriff Mark Essex. If you law enforcement can come up, we have a brief message from law. My name is Mark Essick. I'm the Sheriff of Sonoma County. I'm here to speak to you on behalf of the sheriffs and other law enforcement partners.